Hello, welcome to our demo channel. Chemical name concept. In this lecture, I am going to solve question number 10.6, which is taken from machine design book written by V B Bhandari. In the topic, this question is taken from topic design of spring. Question given to us here is a safety valve. The 3 mm in diameter is to blow off at pressure of 1.2 MPa. It is held on its seat by means of helical compression spring with initial compression of 20 mm. The maximum lift of the valve is 12 mm. The spring index is 6. The spring is made up of pulled round steel wire with ultimate tensile strength of 1400 Nm². The permissible shear stress can be taken as 50% of the strength. Modulus of rigidity is 81,370 Nm². We can calculate wire diameter, main coil diameter, and the number of active coils. So to calculate first wire diameter, as I know, we need to use shear stress formula, which is 8 PD/πD³ × kW. Okay, this is the standard formula which I can use. Here kW is the wall correction factor, which is 4c-1 / 4c-4 + 0.615 / c. as I know, in the given question, c is given to us is 6 for tau. We have a relation tau is a 50% of SUT. So SUT is given to us in this problem is 1400. So the tau will come out as 700. I need to calculate this small d. So I can write this equation as tau is equal to 8 PC/πD² × kW, because the spring index given to us is 6, and spring index is that it is a ratio of capital D by small d. Capital D is a mean diameter, mean coil diameter, and the small d is a wire diameter. Okay, so C is known to us, kW is known to us, tau is known to us, but here one unknown is there also, other than small d, wire diameter, is a load. Okay, load T. So to calculate load, here I need to understand the question. Initial statement, the wall diameter is 40 mm, which is blown, which is controlled by the pressure 1.2 MPa. It means initial load, initial some kind of a load, some amount of load will produce, which is P1. As we know, the load is pressure into area, or pressure is the load upon area. Okay, so pressure here is small p into cross section area, which is related to the safety valve. Pressure is given to us in 1.2 MPa, and the area is a circular in section, or diameter is given to us, wall diameter, which is 40 mm. Pi by 4 d square will be the area, related area in which the pressure will induce some kind of a load. So pressure into area will be the load P1. So the P1 will be come out as pi by 4 into 4 square into 1.2 divided by 4. The value of load will be 15.01. Okay. Sorry, not a 4 square, not 4, it is a 40 square. For 1507. Thousand five hundred seven point 96 Newton will be the initial load by which this safety valve is controlled. After some time with the initial compression, delta is given to us, initial compression 20 mm. For this we are having with this load the deflection or compression displacement is given to us, deflection is given to us is 20 mm. So with the load of P1 which is 1507.96 Newton, the displacement will take place or the initial compression is take place 20 mm. After some time the maximum lift will of the valve will take place around 12 mm. After initial compression of the valve, the 12 mm displacement other than 20 mm will take place, for which the load will also increase. Okay, so del 2 will be the value del 1 plus lift, and the del 1 is 20, del 2 is 12, so the 32 mm will be the del 2 deflection. As I know, load is directly load is related to the displacement. Okay, so I need to calculate P2 for del 2. So P2 by P1 can be written as del 2 by del 1. So from here I can say P2 will become out as 2412736 Newton. How can I say the value of P2 is more than P1? Because del 2 is more than del 1. So to increase the displacement, initial compression, to increase the compression, we need to increase our load. So load will be increased by an amount of 2412 minus 1507. Okay, whatever the value will be come out as, that will be the displacement. So this will be the maximum load and this will be the minimum load by which this displacement will take place in the valve mechanism. Now I wanted to calculate the value of small d, for which I have a formula 8 pd by pi d cube into kw. This formula also can written as 8 pi d square 8 pc pi pi d square into 4 c minus 1 divided by 4 c minus 4 plus 0.615 divided by c in bracket. If I will put the value and shift this d square to here and tau is here, if I am transferring this d square from bottom to right left hand side and this tau to denominator, then d square will be 8 into, here I need to put the maximum load which is 2412.736 Newton, because for maximum load only the maximum shear stress will take place, which is the permissible shear stress. Okay, 2412.7 into c is given to a 6 divided by pi into tau is equal to, tau will be equal to how much, 7 Newton per square. 4 into 6 minus 1 4 into 6 minus 4 plus 0.615 divided by 6. Put all those values into the calculator. 8 into 2412.7 into 6 divided by pi into 700 in bracket 4 into 6 minus 1 divided by 4 into 6 minus 4 plus 0.615 divided by 6. Bracket close. D square will be 65.7 something, and the square root of that value will be 8.12. The d will be come out as 8.12 mm. So approximately this value can be written as 9 mm. This will be the first unknown, and for to calculate the mean dia, I need to use spring index capital D by small d formula. C is known to us as 6, capital D I wanted to calculate, small d is calculated as 9. So the capital D will be come out as 54 mm. Next, third point I wanted to calculate number of active coils. To calculate number of active coils, we need to remember this formula, delta is equal to 8 p d cube into na into gd to power 4, or other formula can be written as 8 p c cube into na into na divided by g to small d. Na equal to can be written as g d into delta divided by 8 p c cube. G is 81370 given to us, modulus of rigidity, small d is calculated as 9 mm, delta is the maximum value of displacement, which is 32 mm, in 8 into load is the difference between 2412.7 minus 1507.9 into C is given to us 6. If we apply this value to this formula and calculator, then our value will be into 32.8 into in bracket 2412.7 minus 1507.96 bracket close into 6 cube, 14.98. Na will be 14.98. Coils. If I put here value difference and deflection will be, if suppose deflection is 32 and load is that much, if I put the value load as a 1507 and delta is, for 1507 delta is 20, then Na will be reduced. Okay, so this is the way you can solve this problem. You can approximate this value as a 15 coil, and if I apply here P as a 1507 and delta is 20, then Na will be reduced to approximately equal to around 6 coils. Okay, so whatever you can, whatever the condition you choose, you need to justify that and you need to understand the concept related to this. If you have any doubt, then comment below this video. Don't forget to subscribe my channel. Thank you. Have a good day.